Let's start off by talking about the big trigger point that we've been tracking pretty closely, the kind of surprise move that we picked up from the Fed, and the kind of tapering news that everybody was expecting came as somewhat of a surprise with no tapering coming in. The question is, the kind of time that we've actually bought, because what a lot of market experts or what of analysts actually say, it's not if tapering is coming or not, but it's a question of when it's actually coming in. So when we talk about this time, this leeway that we've actually got, how are investors viewing it?
In fact, you know, we were actually fortunate to have been traveling in the European and UK region last week when this announcement from the Fed came up. And it had taken by investors by surprise, no doubt. But at the same time, I think the traditional long-only investors are unlikely to step into the risky markets of Asia as a consequence of this. By risky markets, I mean those which have a large current account deficit, like India, Indonesia, and possibly even Thailand, which is not quite there, but is likely to get in there, you know, over the next 1 year or so. The reason that investors are talking about is that the fundamental reasons why these countries have a large current account deficit have not gone away. In case of India, that was fiscal profligacy over the last several years. In case of Indonesia, it was a combination of monetary and fiscal stimulus. And these fundamental reasons have to be tackled on a war footing. There has to be a long, painful adjustment, possibly more so for India. These fundamental reasons are still there, and they have just been postponed or hidden for a longer time as a consequence of this postponement of tapering. So I don't think investors would be enthused to move into these high current account deficit markets. We have seen some degree of short covering over the last 3 or 4 days after this announcement came through. But I don't really think this rally would be fundamentally sustained.